ഷോർട്ട് ഹാൻഡ് ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് ലോവർ 80 വേർഡ്സ് പെർ മിനിറ്റ്. ഇറ്റ് ഗിവ്സ് മീ ഗ്രേറ്റ് പ്ലെഷർ ടു ബി ഇൻ യുവർ മിഡ്സ്റ്റ് ടുഡേ ടു ഇനോഗ്രേറ്റ് ദി ഗോൾഡൻ ജൂബിലി സെലിബ്രേഷൻസ് ഓഫ് ദിസ് ഗ്രേറ്റ് ഇൻസ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂഷൻ ഫൗണ്ടഡ് ബൈ ദ ഫാദർ ഓഫ് ദ നേഷൻ മഹാത്മാഗാന്ധി. ഇൻ ദി ലൈഫ് ഓഫ് എനി ഇൻസ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂഷൻ 50 years ഓഫ് സർവീസസ് ഈസ് എ റെക്കോർഡ് ഓഫ് ലെജിറ്റിമേറ്റ് പ്രൈഡ് ആൻഡ് ഐ കൺഗ്രാചുലേറ്റ് ഓൾ ദോസ് കണക്റ്റഡ് വിത്ത് ദ സഭ ഫോർ ദി ഡെഡിക്കേറ്റഡ് വർക്ക് they have done during this period when Gandhiji was leading our struggle for freedom from foreign rule. He felt that in a multilingual country like ours, a common language which would serve as a link among the several linguistic groups of India was a desideratum in order to forge unity throughout the length and breadth of our country. He therefore chose Hindustani with its deep roots in this soil and its connections with Sanskrit to be country's common language or the Rashtra Bhasha. Though Gandhiji's own mother tongue was Gujarati, he preferred Hindustani to become the Rashtrabhasha because he was convinced that Hindi or Hindustani, which is spoken by a large number of people in northern India and understood over a large part of the rest of the country, was most fitted to serve as the common language. He sent his son, the late Sri Devadas Gandhi, to spread Hindi in the south. This language, which the Sabha sought to spread, was, as Gandhiji said on the occasion of the Silver Jubilee of this Sabha in 1946, really the language of the common people of North India and understood by an overwhelming majority. Ever since its inception, the Sabha has been working for the spread of Hindi in the south, and several lakhs of people have learned this language and appeared and passed the graded examinations conducted by the Sabha. The Sabha is not only popularizing the knowledge of Hindi but is also training teachers to teach Hindi. In recognition of its meritorious service, the Government of India, by an Act of Parliament, declared the Sabha as an institution of national importance, conferring on it the authority to award degrees for proficiency in Hindi and in the teaching of Hindi. Taking advantage of the recognition, the Sabha has started postgraduate course and research in Hindi, and many young men have already been awarded MA and PhD degrees. The government of India have granted recognition to the degrees awarded by the Sabha, and I am sure that many students in the South will utilize the Sabha's service and quality themselves for posts requiring high proficiency in Hindi.